This video topic was requested by my patron, the Badger Queen. If you'd like to become a patron and have your video topic request prioritized, link down below.
We're telling a dramatic story. We're not trying to actually just interact with these characters the way you might interact with people in reality.
Spare Room with Karen Terry.
Hey y'all, and welcome to Spare Room. I'm Karen Terry, and today we're going to talk about writing argument scenes. So we talked about writing action scenes, but typically those are for more physical confrontations. We also talked about building tension, but that typically happens over a period of time. And both of those videos are linked up in the card if you'd like to check them out. So what about the nuts and bolts of an argument? So not a fight scene or an action scene exactly, but a scene of disagreement or yelling. These scenes are still at their core fight scenes, but instead of using our fists or weapons, we're going to use our words. So tip number one is give your argument stakes. An argument is not a conversation or a debate or even two people trying to work it out. So if you want your argument to have tension, give it stakes. What's going to happen if character A gets what they want? What's going to happen if character B gets what they want? What's going to happen if no one gets what they want? Make sure that the answer to these questions are something that impacts the characters. If they're lovers or friends, maybe this argument is something that really impacts that relationship and messes it up. If one character depends on the other, maybe that safety net is removed and the hurt character now has to go fend for themselves or figure things out on their own. If your characters share mutual friends or acquaintances, maybe the argument has ramifications for those relationships. If the characters have built something together, such as a business or creative project, maybe that argument causes the question of ownership of that thing to come up. Whatever the case, make sure the argument has stakes. No one's gonna care if the next time the two characters see each other, they act like the argument never happened. Tip number two, first establish, then escalate the conflict. Put the two characters on opposing sides. Maybe the outcome one character wants is diametrically opposed to the outcome that the other character wants. Or maybe the two characters are working from completely different base assumptions about what they're arguing about. Whatever the case, when you first spark the conflict, you need to establish what is different about the two characters' viewpoints and why. And once you've done that, escalate the conflict. We're telling a dramatic story. We're not trying to actually just interact with these characters the way you might interact with people in reality. So, don't have your character de-escalate the situation. Have them escalate it. Something that that character said hurt? Your character should say something back that's even more hurtful. Don't worry about if this is in the character's nature or not. Everyone gets angry sometimes, and if you did the work to establish what was going on and also give the argument stakes, then it's gonna still feel natural for them to escalate. I know this can be really hard for some role players where they're very conflict averse and they just want to smooth things over like you would in real life, and they don't want to upset their partner. They think like upsetting their character might upset the partner and all of this stuff, but we're writing characters. This isn't reality, so we don't want to do that. In good storytelling, we want conflict. And that brings us to tip number three. Actually have your character try to win. I know that if you tend to be a little bit more passive when it comes to your role plays, this can be really hard. So for this, throw that passive posting out the window. We're going for a dramatic argument. That means your character wants to win. And if they don't for some reason, then go back to the earlier steps and figure out how to establish that argument and what the stakes are in that argument so that your character will want to win. And bonus, if you do this well where both characters want to win the argument, it's going to be really easy for you and your partner to escalate that argument. So keep trying to win until we get to tip number four, which is establish a breaking point. At some point, the argument has to end. Maybe one character walks away from the other character, or one character is so hurt that they can't respond, or maybe one of the characters decides that this is pointless and they don't want to continue the argument anymore. Once you've escalated the argument to a fever pitch, throw in that breaking point that's going to make the argument just stop. This is the official breakup. This is ripping up the contract. This is throwing all of your stuff in your car and moving out. So, reach that breaking point and end the scene without actually resolving the argument. And that brings me to tip number 5. End with no resolution. Remember, the point of the scene that we're talking about is not a conversation or a debate. We're trying to have an argument. That means at the end of the scene, one of the characters should be hurt, if not both of the characters being hurt. No true resolution should be reached. And now the characters have to deal with the ramifications of that argument that we established when we established the stakes. So as you can see, this isn't really super different from building tension or writing action scenes or things like that. We're just applying it to the case of an argument. And the key here really is that ending part where we don't leave an actual resolution. So to recap, first we give the argument stakes. Then we establish, then escalate the conflict. Next, make sure your characters are actually attempting to win. Then reach your breaking point and the argument. And lastly, end the scene without resolution. So what do you guys think? Is this how you tend to write arguments? If not, I'd be really curious about your methods. Let me know down below. If this is how you write arguments, let me know how it works for you. I'm really curious about that as well. And if this helped you improving your argument writing, I'd also love to know about that. All of that down below. And of course, as always, don't forget to make it a great day.